Good day, grade 11th. Today we are going to look at finding a general solution when a restriction is given. So what we are going to do is find the general solution like we did before, and then substitute values of k to find the solution within that repetition. So that means after finding the general solution, we'll substitute k for the first repetition on the positive x-axis, and then k equals to negative 1 on the for the first repetition on the negative x-axis, depending on what the restriction is going to be. Okay, so we are going to do an example. It says find theta if theta lies between negative 360 and 720. So as you can see here, if you can go back to the diagram that we did last week, when we are moving from negative 360 falls under the first repetition on the left hand side, and then we've got 720, which is the first repetition on the right hand side. So it means that the values of k are going to be k equals to negative 1, and then k is equals to 0, which is our 0 to 360, this one. And then we've got the first repetition, which is k equals to 1. Okay, so like I said, we just solve as we did. So this is an example that we have. We have sine half theta equals to 0.85. Now, because we have this, which is special, we need to let it be equals to c, so that it will be easy for us to solve. So that's what I did. Then I did my analysis. Sine is positive in the first quadrant and in the second quadrant. Okay, so I find C in the first quadrant. It gives me 55.59. And then because it's a general solution, I'm going to write plus K times 360, where K is an integer. Okay, then I do the second quadrant. C, number 2, would have been 180 minus 55.59, and it is 124.41 times k, plus k times 360, where k is an integer. Now remember that we didn't have c, so we have to bring back what was originally in the question. So in the place of c, I put a half theta. I put it back where it was. So a half theta is equal to 59, on the right hand side, and then you divide by half on both sides. So when you divide by half on both sides, remember, divide by half, not 2, because this is a half. Okay, so when you divide by half, this it's like you multiply by 2, so it becomes 111.18 times k plus k times 720, because again, this 306, when you divide it by half, it gives you 720. You divide by that number throughout, you divide everything. Okay, then you do the same on the other side. You find, you divide by a half as well, and then you get theta, which is 248.82 plus k times 720. So now these two are your general solutions. So that is what you would have, that is where you would have ended if the question had not given you this restriction. So now what do you do after that? Then you substitute the value of k in each of the thetas that you have. So that means I'm going to substitute k is equals to negative 1, k is equals to 1, and k is equals to 0. But k is equals to 0 will still give us this, because the 720 will disappear. But I'm going to do it anyway so that you guys can see. Right? So theta plus, so you write this exactly as it is when then you substitute here. So negative 1 negative 1 times 720 will then give me negative 608.82 degrees. Okay, then when you substitute k is equals to 0, I get 111. If I substitute k is equals to 1, I get 831. Now you see I've got this cross and tick. Now, if you check this one, negative 608, it is now below the restriction. The restriction said we must have values that are between negative 300. So this must be the smallest value. So this one is smaller than negative 360. So it doesn't qualify to be our answer. So we leave it out. And then this one as well. If you check here, 831 is now over 720. So it also doesn't qualify as our answer. Okay. And then we move on. We do the same on the right hand side. We substitute k is equals to negative 1, 0, and 1. And then again, if you check here, negative 471 doesn't qualify. This one qualifies. This one also doesn't qualify. So that means in the given domain, negative 360 to 720, there are only two solutions, which is 111.18 and 248.82 degrees. So now sometimes you may find that after you have done your K, after you have substituted your K's, you have only one solution. Sometimes you can have three solutions. So you just choose your solutions according to what qualifies to be within this given domain. So like I've written there, within the given domain, there are only two solutions. So please remember that you only have to do this part when the question has given you a restriction. If there's no restriction, it means your answer will just end here, will end there, and there's no need for that. And now you can do this in your calculator. But for starters, you can do it like I did so that you can be able to select the correct values for yourself, and then you write it down like I have. So after everything, you can't just leave it there. You have to then select the correct values and then write them as a solution. And now you see that if now there is a solution, there's no plus k times 720 because now you were given a restriction, and in that given restriction, there are only two answers. So you write only those two answers. Okay, I hope that is clear. So please do exercise 12, number 3, 4, 5, and 6. Thank you.